I'm gonna ride today. I wasn't planning on it, but I got everything done really early. And I typically stay until 2 and it's only 12:45. I haven't ridden any of these horses yet, so I'm excited. Like most things in my life, I'm probably overly confident. I am kind of a prodigy, just like as a person, so I should be fine. I just left the barn. I did ride, which was so fun. I rode bareback, which I've never done before, and I was petrified, but I did it. I've never even ridden in an English saddle before. It was a really cool experience. I'm grateful that the horse let me do that with her. I'm disgusting and I'm starving, so I'm gonna take a shower. We have Taylor's birthday dinner tonight, which I'm pumped for. And then we have another birthday party that we're going to after her birthday party, her birthday dinner. So I think it's gonna be really fun. I started volunteering at this barn. I grew up riding at this barn, but I only did it for like less than a year. So I help out there on Monday and Friday from like 9 to 2. Also, you guys, I'm riding this horse bareback. This is a big horse, okay? I've never even used like English reins before. I have no idea what I'm doing. The man who's like training me speaks like barely any English. Thank God I can understand like this much. Really conversational, basic Spanish. But yeah, so I'm like trying to maneuver how to ride this horse bareback. Never rode this horse before. And I'm trying to understand it all in a foreign language to me. Yeah, and I did it. So self-confidence really does prevail. I'm gonna take a very intense shower, eat food, come back to life, and then I'm gonna get ready for Taylor's birthday. We're going to Croatia in 9 days. So I'm really excited. That's gonna be really fun. Our actual birthday's on the 5th and mine's on the 9th, and we'll both be there with our moms. I was gonna comb my hair, but I just can't bring myself to do it. And Sarah's already here, and I have 15 minutes, so I'm putting it in a braid, as always. This is Taylor's dress that I borrowed because I didn't have anything else to wear. Do you guys wanna do fit checks?
This is my fit.
I can narrate for you. Okay, where's the dress from?
Baby Boo.
Dress is from Baby Boo. Vibes.
Yeah, there we go.
White heels
from, I actually don't even,
size 7.
8.
This is Aritzia.
Oh my god, cute.
Has a little flap, you know. Forever 21, $7.99.
Dior.
Nordstrom Rack. Your dad's closet.
Oh my god.
I always want to include them, but then they say things that I have to cut out.
Diamonds Direct, Greece, Santorini, of course, and then Diamonds Direct.
What I was wearing.
I already know you're wearing a gown.
She's like, all right, a gown.
A gown.
Oh, it's a video.
Yeah, this is my YouTube vlog.
Oh, fun.
Oh, that's yours.
I also
get the candle.
Wait, move the angle down a little bit.
Okay, well,
what video? Get the video.
Is that right? Can you talk?
Hi vlog. It's currently 1 p.m. I had a rough morning. I'm just recovering today. I ordered some food, took a shower. It's 8 o'clock Saturday night and I'm getting ready to go out again. Godspeed to myself. I'm probably not gonna drink, but I am going to dinner with a couple of girls and then we'll probably go out after, but today was just embarrassing, honestly. I'm embarrassed for myself. I never really am hungover to the point of like immobilization, but today was the day. I was just so violently humbled by my own anatomy. I ordered food. I did get a manicure, which was my accomplishment of the day, but it was rough. It was really, really rough. Last night was really, really fun. I haven't had that much fun in a long time. Going to a new restaurant to get some Italian food because what's a girl dinner if not pasta? I ordered Vietnamese pho today, which if you've never had pho, it's literally like a cure-all. Anytime I'm sick or immobilized as I was today, I get pho and it heals me. Really, really it does. And then I had chicken fingers and they were the best chicken fingers I've had ever, I think. This is the La Roche Purifying Foaming Cleanser. I used to use the gentle hydrating one and then I switched and that's really when my skin started clearing up because I think this is better for my skin type. This is the Caudalie Brightening Serum, or the Venoperfect Brightening Dark Spot Serum. If you are sensitive to vitamin C or you don't like vitamin C, this is like the best alternative. And it's supposed to be like some crazy high percentage more effective than vitamin C. And I do really notice a difference with like how bright my skin looks. Plus I just trust anything that Caudalie does. It is expensive, but I think it's really, really worth it. Normally I use the Caudalie Rich Cream, but I'm out of it, tragically. So this is the Cicelie Black Rose Skin Infusion Cream I've been using. It's honestly really similar. French skincare and I are just besties, we really are. This is my favorite eye cream ever, I think. This is the Ren Brightening Dark Circle Eye Cream. I also love everything that Ren does because their products are just so clean and their ingredients are so good. My two favorite sunscreens right now, this one is the Image Skincare Prevention Plus Clear Solar Gel. And I just got the Summer Friday Shade Drops. Super late to the party, I know, but I am a fan. I do understand the hype. Especially just because getting high quality sunscreens that are not like hellaciously expensive is hard. I don't think I'm gonna wear makeup because I just cannot bring myself to do that today. And I also feel like my skin needs a break. This is the Ellis Brooklyn Salt Perfume. Oh my god, it just smells like a fresh, clean mermaid. You know what I mean? Like you just jumped out of the ocean. You already know, I never shut up about this stuff. Does anyone else have this issue where one side of their hair stays curled and the other one like doesn't? This one always stays curled and this one goes straight. And it does this every single time no matter what I do. It's just, it's working against me. I don't know why. Okay. Let's go.
What are you getting done today?
Disport.
Nefertiti.
The Nefertiti.
The what?
Nefertiti lift. It's beautiful.
Okay.
I can dab if you want me to.
I know, I have a tendency.
It's okay.
I need a photo. I was trying to get a photo.
Okay, well, somehow I've been convinced that I'm getting work done. I talked to her and I think that I'm gonna get Botox in my chin. Like a little bit of filler here.
Just filler here. Raise it since that's so raised. It fixes your under eye lines there. It fixes that, it raises that, and it fixes that. It
lifts both. So we'll see. I told her I really love how I look and I've never wanted to get work done. And like in photos and stuff and on camera, I feel like sometimes I look just like a little bit harder than I'd like. And it's pretty minor what she's doing, so I don't think it's gonna be like crazy.
It's incredibly minor.
Yeah, it's really minor, but I'm excited. To see.
You won't notice anything with the cheeks besides the fact that you're gonna look more youthful and younger.
Oh, that's good. People already think I'm 17, so.
I can't work.